Hi and welcome back to my video series, Leave It. This is Venus Flytrap and this is just a step up from closed fist. With this we're also going to begin to add a leave it command. Now my dogs don't have a leave it command, so Koji's not really going to understand leave it, but he has an auto leave it, so he'll get the hang of it anyway. For those that have watched my food etiquette series, you will see that I basically give no commands in that. There's a command that gets the dogs to understand that it's their food and they can take it, and a command to share, but I don't give them any commands to leave or anything like that, or sit or anything. I'm the world's most laziest trainer. I really don't like spending copious amounts of time training my dogs. So I train as quickly and as efficiently as I can because I just want it over and done with. I want them to learn what I'm trying to teach them and that's it, and to move on. And I also don't like talking to my dogs that much, so I basically set up everything that's auto. So if I'm walking and I stop, dogs automatically go into a sit. When they go into a sit, they automatically go into a stay. When they sit, they also automatically go into a leave, and they automatically go into a calm. If they get bored or I stop for any period of time, they automatically go into a down. That down means they automatically go into a stay and also into a calm and a leave. So I'm super lazy for that, so I have auto everything. All right, so for this, and for people that want a verbal command, we will just use leave it. At the very end, I'll do a video that shows you how to take all these exercises, skip the command and just make them auto. So you still will need something out and about in the real world to stop the dog. You know, like I said, these are great for food. Having the auto is great for food. In the real world, if you want to use something like leave it, so the dog leaves, you know, another barking dog, a car, you know, a kid on a bike, a kid running or whatever, poop on the ground, trash on the ground, food on the ground, you're going to need a command. So you're going to need something like leave it or a sound. So for me, if I need to use it, I just use a correction sound. Again, I don't incorporate a leave it. And the dog knows that it's got to stop what it's doing. So that's all I use on the outside. But around the house or on picnics or at somebody else's house where there's food and that, I have everything absolutely auto. And if they go to break it for whatever reason, again, I'll just use a correction sound. All right. So anyway, the technique, Koji. You'll see there, Koji's gone straight into his auto calm. You're going to have treats in one hand. And all this is going to do is when the dog goes to it, the hand closes. When the dog's calm and not trying to get it, the hand's open. Alright? So, you initially start back here. You don't want to take it and stick it under the dog's nose like this. Because your dog's not going to be trained, your dog's going to take it. So you're going to set your dog up to fail. Start back here. So if the dog does go to lunge, you can close it. And I'm looking for the same thing. A lot of people just want the dog to ignore it. I keep wanting a step further from my dog because I want this dog to look at me in the eyes and I want this dog to focus on me. Because that way I'm teaching focus at the same time. Or I'm reinforcing focus. I'm also reinforcing calmness. And I'm also helping the dog control his impulse. So I'm teaching impulse control. So I'm getting a whole bunch of lessons out of this. And I told you I'm lazy. It's the way I want to do it. I don't want to just teach leave it. I want to teach the dog a whole bunch of things at one time. And it just makes it easy or reinforce things I'm working on as well. And yes. So all you're going to do is put it out. Slowly open your hand. If your dog goes to lunge, close your hand. Alright, don't correct your dog because you're still teaching the dog the concept of leave it. As I begin to open my hand, I put it there, I go leave it. Good. He doesn't know what it is, but he understands he's not supposed to take this food. So he's just going to look at me. And then I close it again, take the hand away. Nice and slowly. I don't want quick hand movements and get the dog all excited. Then I put it back, leave it, and I open it. And I just wait. Yes, so even when he knows I've just taken the treat out, I wait until he then pays attention to my eye. Looks into my eyes. So this is all Venus flytrap is. It's beginning to give a verbal command. And I begin to open the hand now. So it makes it far more tempting. When the hand was closed, that's tempting. But when it's open, it's far more tempting. And I'm waiting for that dog to look up here in my eyes and focus on me. And if I want to make this stronger, one of the things I do is this. I make him look at me, yes, for longer periods of time. Alright? The other thing, too, is when you first start doing it, and I say leave it, and I open this. Yes. I'll mark the dog as soon as it looks in the eyes. Don't worry about making it look at you for long periods. Get the dog that what you want it to do is ignore this, look at you. Ignore this, look at you. Here's the food, look at me. Here's the food, look at me. That's all I want. So I'll mark the dog the split second it looks at me. And then I'll start to extend time once the dog gets that. So once the dog continually does that, then I start extending time and make it stronger. Alright, so it's a really simple exercise. Start with it back here so you've got plenty of time. And if the dog's overexcited and doesn't have much, you know, control, it's going to go for it for a lot. Eventually it gets the idea, and then you can start moving it in closer and closer. Alright, so it's very simple.
Good.
And it's just a great exercise to teach. Hope that helps. We'll see you in the next one.